Hello, it's Sarah. And I did another art doll. I'm just going to go up a little. I think I'll get her all in the shot better. This is a large one. She's very tall. I did her with the Botanical Tea paper pad from Graphic 45. I just wanted to do something not Christmassy for a minute. And I like how she turned out. I used the wings are actually from the Julie Nutting, and I could have had them ready to go. I have several, or I actually ordered three of these different ornaments, and I haven't painted them yet. I prepped them, but I didn't paint them. There's a couple tutorials out there on these. Oh, excuse me. And I ordered three different ones. She's kind of a Santa girl, so I gessoed these already. And this one's kind of Christmassy. I think her name is Holly, or one of them is named Holly, because these are all kind of the Christmas ones that I got. And they all come with a set of wings. So I had three sets of wings. One of them's missing, but they're big. They're the nice size wings. And they're again in that, like, I forget what kind of wood it's called, but I thought I would try those because I think these are cute without the wings. You don't need wings on these. These are perfectly fine for ornaments without the wings. So I thought I'm going to use one of those anyway. So I did. I painted them and I stamped on the back of this one and I did the embossing on the sides. But so that's the back. I also used a wooden doily. This is from Michaels and they were on clearance a while back, so I got a few. I cut it just at the bottom and I just used my tonic scissors. So I just kind of pried it off and broke it. And that way it didn't bump into the wings or to the top of the doll body. I made her, actually I painted these and I kind of wish I'd just done the gold. Because this is that gold again on the halo, I guess we'll call it. And I love that gold. I did stickle the edges and I used these gold balls up against the edge too to give it a little dimension. But I love how that turned out. And that's the embossing on the edge on the side. I used green Inca gold for that because there was a lot of green in the paper. And like I said, I did the beads for the arms and the legs, and I love how they turned out. I used a couple of wood veneers, but not too many embellishments, just really used the paper to embellish with. And that's basically it. Of course, stickles and the dimensional paint, the tulip paint. I put a piece of ribbon at her neck where I connected the jump rings. But she's pretty cute. I can hang her. I have her hanging right here on my wall. If I can get her to go up there while I'm on camera. So cute, right? I mean, I just wanted to have one for myself and not just all Christmassy, so. But what do you think of those wings? They're actually, I could have probably did them down a little bit or whatever. I like them up a little, but that is the pearl, white pearl color, the Martha Stewart paint. So they look silver, which was why I was like, I wished I'd paint them gold, but really, I mean, I used silver findings on the jewelry part, so, I mean, I did use gold too, though. So silver and gold, it's fine. I mix my metals now. And that's the cute little face from the new printables I got. I love that face. So there she is. All right, you guys, that's it. Thanks for watching.